Hey guys, in our tutorial today we'll talk about product options in OpenCart. We'll show you how to create options and assign them to products. As you know, the different products may come in different sizes, colors, materials, etc. The options in OpenCart are a perfect way to utilize and embrace the different features of a product. We can create as many options as we want and later assign them to products. Let's get started. First, as usual, let's log into our admin panel. From the dashboard, we should go to Catalog, Options. There, we see a listing of all the available options in our store. To add a new one, we should click on the Add New button. A new window opens up, and here we should add the details of our new option. In the tutorial, we'll make a new option for t-shirt sizes. So, in our option name, we type in t-shirt sizes. Afterwards, we need to select the option type. OpenCart offers a variety of different option types: checkboxes, images, text, date, etc. In our case, we want to make the product option mandatory, so we'll be using the radio buttons as an option of choice. In the sort order box, we should select the display position in the product page. In our case, we'll add 0, so that it shows up on the first place. This is just in case there are other options associated with the same specific product. After that, we should start adding the option values. For our example, we'll add small, medium, large, and extra large. Each option value can have an image as well, but we won't add one for this tutorial. The option values will be ordered as per their sort order value. We click on the Save button, and our new option has been created. In order to assign it to a product, we should go to the Product Edit page by going to Catalog and then selecting Products. We choose which product we want to assign an option to and click on the Edit button next to it. Afterwards, we click on the Option tab, and in the empty field, we start typing the name of the option. An autocomplete with the available options opens up, and we select among the various t-shirt sizes that we have added before. We then select whether we would like the option field to be required. The required option means that customers will not be able to purchase a product unless they select at least one option. From here, we choose which option values to add to our product. In our case, we'll add all of them. From the Option Value Select field, we select the option value. In the Quantity field, we type in the stock of this option. If we, for example, have 10 t-shirts that are size small and they're all in stock, we should type in 10. We then select whether we want the stock to be subtracted if a t-shirt of this type has been purchased. If a product with an option has a different price, gives a different amount of reward points, or weighs more than the general product, then we should add the difference here using a plus or a minus sign. For example, some colors may be more expensive than others, and some materials might be heavier than others. In our case, however, this is not necessary, so we'll leave those boxes empty. After we have finished editing the options, we click on the Save button. Now, let's check if we have added the product option just as we wanted. The easiest way to do this is to go to the storefront and look for the product we edited. There it is. So, we're opening the product now. So, here is the product with the product options next to the product image just as we added them. Great! Well, that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, write them up in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to like the video and hit the subscribe button for more great content coming along.